creativity is not simply original thinking. After all, both of these paragraphs are equally original. They're both unusual. And both give voice to sentences that have probably never been uttered or written before these writers penned them. So for something to be deemed creative, however, it must not only be original, but it also must be useful and adaptive and solve a problem. James Joyce's paragraph does that because it's part of solving the problem of telling a story. The second paragraph is not creative because it's not useful and doesn't solve a problem. By useful, we clearly do not mean pragmatic. James Joyce's novel was useful in the sense that he was the first novelist to write from the perspective of inside a person's unconscious mind. It has been so esteemed and deemed creative by experts and readers of English literature because it presented a powerful study of unconscious human thought and emotion. It can be useful in a literary, artistic, or aesthetic sense in that people are inspired by it and make use of it in their own creations. The second quote is equally original, but does not solve an important problem in any useful or adaptive way. By itself, these phrases may be interesting, but together they're not terribly coherent or were not made with the intent of shedding light on the inner workings of a human mind, as was Ulysses. So, creative thought and behavior requires two things: originality or novelty of the thought and behavior, and that thought and behavior has to be useful and adaptive solution to some kind of problem. So new forms of art and literature, architecture, science, technology, and business change their fields. The field is different after the insight or innovation. Creativity changes things for the better. Of course, the usefulness or originality may not be immediately seen or appreciated. Truly creative thought and behavior may be well ahead of its time, so the evaluation of creativity is not limited to the here and now.